Hey, Codsworth.
Mr. Sebastian, give me the word, sir, and I'll initiate my search protocol.
Hey, guys, I probably showed you a clip right before this where I got wind of the fact that apparently Codsworth will actually say a lot of different names, but Keith is not on that list, unfortunately. 925 names confirmed so far, I think, and Keith is not one of them. They needed all that space for ASDF and ass face and boobies and other names like that, and Marky Poo. But anyway, I found out how to change my name, which is you press the tilde key, you type show special menu, and it brings this menu back up. You can't edit your stats from here, I don't think. You can't change these? You can. Oh. I guess you could just respec your character if you wanted to. But most importantly, for the topic I'm talking about, you can change your name from this menu. So now I'm Sebastian. Since Keith doesn't work, I'm just going to use the channel name, because that works. Alright, and that little trick out of the way. Let's also do this one real quick. FOV 9090. Oh, sweet goodness. Alright, so now we'll be a little less claustrophobic playing this game, because we can see our surroundings a little bit more. Oh, that's nice. That's nice. I think you can go fairly high, too. Let's try something stupid like FOV 120. Alright, so, now that we're all nauseous and stuff... I mean, honestly, it looks kind of cool. I think I'm seeing too much of my arms, honestly. But, I think when you get the FOV 2... Wow, yeah, you can see everything when you get the FOV huge, but I think it also reaches a point where you maybe can't... Everything looks too far away compared to what it's supposed to look like, so... I'm gonna stay with 90-90 for now. The default is like 80 or something, and it's like... It's too close. It bothered me a bit. Yeah, this is what it's supposed to look like, more or less. Is he gonna say my name?
I'm afraid I won't be able to repave the driveway anytime soon.
Yeah, we can't really spawn a conversation the same way. So, let's take a look around the area. I need to figure out how to... Oh yeah, there's also a command, I think, for changing the FOV on this thing. Anyway... There's Concord. We might as well head in that direction. There's a truck shop over here. Let's see what we can find along there. That's... Wait, what exit? Hang on a second. What's this? Oh, that's just Sanctuary, just in general. I was like, why is there a weird little man icon on my map? There's a few things going on around here. I think the, like, base building thing is involved somewhere around here. So I could spend a long time slowly scavenging this whole area, and I probably will eventually. Ooh, there's just grenades in the trash can. Cool. That's where I'd hope to find grenades. That's roughly in term with why they sealed all those grenades shut. Sealed all those mailboxes shut when the Pope came to visit, for example. Hello! Still seeing dead people everywhere, but now, they're recently dead people. Stimpaks, ammo, ooh, shotgun. And clothes that make me look like I'm not from the vault. Which, if, depending on how what they decide to address from a role-playing perspective, could be handy in some contexts. I almost said concepts. I'm like, that's not how senses work. So the intro reminded me of something that I completely forgot about Fallout, which is that we weirdly, like, fast-forward through time. There's a weird thing where, like, we had a crazy technological advancement, and then we go, like... That's like culture just stagnates for like 100 years, and then the war happens and wipes everyone out. Hey, doggy. Oh, it's a German Shepherd. That's like the third best dog or something. Hello? Slightly freaked out by the fact that he has eyebrows that look like a human face a little too much. Hey, buddy. Are you more durable than dog meat from the Fallout 3? Because he died every 5 minutes. I think I left him somewhere.
Hey, boy. What are you doing out here all by yourself?
You seem like an okay guy.
Okay, then. Let's stick together.
Well, that was fast. Well, this is immediately a less lonely place, so you press E while facing him to issue commands. Oh, where are you going? Alright.
How you doing, buddy?
He didn't talk at all. Oh, he meant me talk. That you're saying, like, tell the dog to speak.
Hey, boy, you know any tricks?
Aww. Headshot. No.
Hey.
How you doing, buddy? Hey, boy. Think you can find something for me?
That yawn.
Think you can find any goodies, boy?
Alright, let's see how this goes. Scavenger dog. You any good? Oh, I didn't find anything. Now he's sad. Hey. Well, let's just sort of,
over here.
Hey. Let's just sort of completely fill him with that sense of,
How you doing, buddy?
Sense of defeat. Let's see. Whoa. I'm sorry, what was that sound? Oh, hello. Excuse me. Hi. There we go. I'm gonna have to ask you to fuck off. Oh, goodness. There's a sight, huh? Let's try to get the dog, jeez. Wow, they just come right out of the ground. Did they do that before? I don't remember that happening before. I think the Morats were just kind of around all the time. Alright, they managed to make them a little intimidating. Wow. Alright. There's definitely something to the whole concept of watching something just go flying at you in slow motion like that. You're like, oh, fuck. Look at that. Yeah. What type of coolant would you like to get? Because we don't have gas, because we're from the future. Space cars. It's such a weird society, because it's future and past at the same time in a weird way. Because their culture stagnated in Fallout. So it feels like they're like from the 40s or 20s or whatever the hell. Gidjup buttercup head? Like parts of a body? Like a robot or something? Hello, doggy. Boston Bugle. Case closed on crime. Boss Eddie Winter. Or crime boss Eddie Winter. Let's see. But since their culture stagnates, it makes it feel like the Fallout society, it feels like the nukes went off in the past at some point when they didn't actually. Ooh, cigarette cartons. Pretty sure those are still valuable. Gidja Buttercup. Oh, it's a horse. I think I've seen that sign before, actually. Anything inside? Anyone gonna come out the other side of this thing? Not hearing anyone at the moment. Lack of broadcasters. We need to go find ourselves a three dog. I'll take a wrench. That seems like a tool. Hello. Alright, I've known you for 5 minutes now. You've already been impaled. I'm so sorry. We're never gonna make it as a dog owner. Does that thing work? I think it does work. Oh, a whole stash of caps. Well, not very well stashed. Rat away, buff out, crisp your squirrel bits. This was someone's base, apparently. Let's go ahead and try to use that hollow tape that we haven't used yet. Hi, honey.
Oopsie. No. Fingers away. There we go. Okay. Just say it. Right there. Yay. Hi, honey. Listen, I don't think that Sean and I need to tell you how great of a father you are. But we're going to anyway. Isn't that right? You are kind and loving. Funny. That's right. And patient. So patient. Patience of a saint, my mom used to say. Look. With Sean and us all being home together, it's been an amazing year. But even so, I know our best days are yet to come. There'll be changes, sure. Things we need to adjust to. You'll rejoin the civilian workforce, and I'll shake the dust off my law degree. But everything we do, no matter how hard, we do it for our family. Say goodbye, Sean. Bye-bye. Say bye-bye. Come on. Bye, honey. We love you.
Well, there's fun feelings. Way to bury just fully engulf him in the revenge fantasy situation we gotta go through here where, yeah, he's getting a reminder of who he lost after they're gone. Business entries. Do I want to go through this? Safe storage? Jim, take care of the barrels before you leave tonight. Inspectors are coming first thing in the morning. Just hide them with the others. We'll figure out a long-term solution later. Hey, if nature's going to favor us with a cave right below the shop, who am I to argue? Hello? There's a cave under the shop? That seems worthwhile. Alright, Rosa Restoration. That Rosa Widow in Sanctuary Hills is restoring an old classic Coverga with her son. Nice woman. Pretty. Kids like that... Kid seems like kind of a brat, but I guess that's the point of her doing this project with him. Anyway, she's been doing a hell of a job. I was amazed at how much her and the kid have been able to do on their own. The only reason she even came to me is because the engine is out of her depth. I'm sure we can help her out. New equipment installed. It's actually good finding out what's around here because we could find loot. Took some wrangling with the head office, but we finally got all the tools we need to machine our own parts. No more having to pay for Coverga factory parts the next time they change the spec of the damn fastener. Just take one we got and trim the excess down until it fits. Alright, service logs. Is this going to be anything noteworthy? Probably just little notes about some vehicles. Oh yeah, these are just notes I'm gonna avoid for now. So there's a cave under this place and they've been stashing stuff there. That's pretty damn noteworthy, I'd say. Hey doggy, you find anything around here? Alright, so where can I find a cave? There's a downward cliff over here. Oh yeah. I'm gonna find a cave, it's gonna be along one of these slopes, right? Don't see it off the bat. Let's see if anything popped up on the map locally. Oh, there's a low point over there by the stream. Interesting note that it actually says cleared on the map. So it helps you keep track of which places you've already gotten the loot out of. I'm gonna take a quick run back towards the shore really quick. Just to see if I can find anything about this cave. That could be where those creatures came from. Maybe there's a trap door out back. Ooh. Jingles, moon money. Hard hat. Could use that as a hat at some point. We have a workbench. Ooh! Hello. Oh, fuck you. Fuck you. Get out of here, life. Oh, goodness. Okay, I don't like... Don't like. No likey. Oops. Stop. You're moving too much. Making me mess up. How do I cancel? Right click. Okay, yeah, this guy's freaking out a little bit too much for me. There we go. Where the hell did those come from? I'm taking radiation damage, reducing my max health. Oh no. So you can transfer stuff here? I can roast some baked bloatfly? Alright. Why not? I think this one's new for me. Yeah, I don't think we had access to this before. Oh. Convenient, we just have a workstation and stuff like that just right around the base around here. See, where's the other one? Hello? Alright, so... We've taken radiation poison. Is it shown here? Apparently that it must be that 10 right there. So let's look into some aid. Perhaps some Radaway. Gotta have some of that. Yeah, there we go. It'll do minus 300 rads. So what is my exact... I want to find my exact rad stat before I just throw that away. It says 10, but that seems like it'd be like radiation... Where is my radiation shown on this thing? This seems like it'd be my resistance or something like that. Huh. I think I might come back to this later. When I get a better idea of exactly how radiation's shown, I'll figure out whether or not I want to spend something on it yet. And where can I find this cave? That's the same place I checked already. Hey, dog. Want to take a quick little run over here by the lake. See if we can find an opening. Hello. Hello, Stimpak. Ammo. Good, fine. Why is there a safe that's open in the middle of nowhere and no one took... How did it open and how did that person not take all the stuff inside? Alright, I figured down here by the stream is probably where there's an opening. Hey, freaky cow. What? Are we fighting? Oh, there we go. Radiation is that red part of your health bar. Are you attacking or are you just hanging out? Oh, I think it's attacking me. Unless it's something else. Oh, he's checking right the hell out. I don't think we have to worry about him. Alright, let's check for a cave. Oh. Maybe not so much luck yet. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna find the cave right away. Might find it in the future. Let's go ahead and just head down slope, though. What was that? Plants? There we go. Getting that open world survival experience. So let's head down to Concord. I'm sure it's full of friendly people that aren't mutants, and don't have guns, and aren't terrible. This is nice enough. Am I hitching every now- am I like teleporting a little forward a little bit? That's weird. Hello. Anyone around? Real quiet around here. Let's see, dog.
Heads up. How you doing, buddy?
Can you find anyone around here?
Hey, boy. Think you can find something for me? Any bad guys around, buddy?
Come on, buddy. Let's see how good you are at this. Didn't find anything. Do we trust him? There's just caps everywhere, damn. Oh, Nuka-Cola Quantum. There we go. It's a little weird starting out this way because we kind of don't have a goal yet. We have the vague idea of gotta find who took my son, but we're kind of just walking on out. Found a dog. Dog, move a little. There we go. Here, let's head down this place a little bit. Welcome to Concord. Hey, level 2. That pop up on its own? No, you hold tab. Here we go, let's learn. So, intelligence is a measure of overall mental acuity. So do I put it into that slot? Do I pick something down here? Oh, requires one charisma. So I can put one star into one of these things. So agility. Non-automatic pistols do 20% more damage. Looks like you can put multiple points into that. Or is that what that even means? Oh! I think they might be saying that it would require... No, never mind. I was thinking maybe it just means that it requires one star out of the 5 that I have because it's agility, but... Oh, maybe it does mean that. Lots going on here. Let's see. Is there a charisma-related skill? Vendor stuff. Not super interesting. Charming and dangerous. That's the lady killer one. Lone Wanderer. Who needs friends anyway? When adventuring without a companion, you take 15% less damage, and carry weight increases by 50. You can carry more when you don't have a companion, that's interesting. Now easier pickpocketing. Non-automatic rifles do more damage. View a target's specific damage resistances in VATS, that sounds interesting. Can I just click on that from here? Oh yeah, so you can just sort of skip all the way down to here. So... That's great. So now when I open VATS, I can actually see what the resistances are of my opponent. And potentially change what I'm doing accordingly. Incentivizing having more items in my inventory to switch between. Oh, gunfire. Let's run towards it, that's the safe thing to do. Water. Radiation bad. I walked into it anyway, didn't I? Oh, hello. Maybe he's not a bad guy. He hasn't attacked us yet. He's the first human we've seen. Dog's in a hurry. So, a few supplies around here. You got some Nuka-Cola for me? Yeah, you do. Yeah, you do. Hey, oh, well now it's just called a raider. That kind of gives it away. Alright! First person we find, we sneak up on and shoot in the back of the head. And for some reason I wasn't using stealth, because I forgot that I have that apparently. That thing that I built my character for. Oh, look at them, they're fighting someone. Yeah, they are. Uh-oh. Dog?
Yo, psst.
Can I tell him to hide? I don't want to get shot. It's kind of in the open, being dumb. Let's see. They're all the way out there. How many raiders do we have around here? Oh, you can cycle like that. So now I know how to cycle between body parts. Mouse wheel or WS or highlight the individual part. Seems like they're doing just fine though. Someone's having no trouble taking them out because they're all getting wiped out one by one. Got him. He's gonna sneak up behind him. This gives me an opportunity. Get up close for the proper shots without taking damage along the way. Uh-oh. Got him. Good job, buddy.
Up here, on the balcony. I've got a group of settlers inside. The raiders are almost through the door. Grab that laser musket and help us, please!
There's a laser musket? Sounds like fun. Also, I'm gonna take all these guys' stuff. Oh, hello. This is one of your guys, huh? If I dress up like him, will they trust me more? Ooh. Oh my god, there's so much opportunity for sweet loot. Alright, really quickly here. Let's try to dress up. In things that might actually make sense for my situation. Apparel. So right now, I am wearing Vault 111 jumpsuit. 5 damage resistance with lightning. 10 radiation. I assume lightning is energy damage, as opposed to like physical damage. Oh yeah, there's physical damage. So raid leathers gives you physical resistance. Sack hood with hoses gives you 5 radiation damage. And probably makes you terrifying. Ooh, 4 and 2. Raider chest piece. Except it makes you a raider. Leather chest piece, 3 and 10. That's decent. Hard hat will give me 4 physical resistance. Oh shit, drifter gives me 5, 7. There's something to go for now. Alright. I have a fair amount of weapon options now. Do I want to switch? He said to use a laser musket. Let's give it a shot. Alright. Where are your friends at? Oh, they want me to charge inside. Okay. Hang on a second. I was just trying to remember how to do third person. Look at this guy. Alright. You can hardly even tell that I've never been in the apocalypse before. I adapted to shooting people really quickly. Oh wait, that voice message indicated that I was from the military. Friend? Not friend, as it turns out. And apparently I can shoot his left arm from here. Seems not entirely give it a shot. Why not? I hate your arm. Stop having an arm. Well, that didn't work out for him. Buddy? Buddy. Oh crap. Reload. Reload. It only fires like a couple times. Oh, you have to like crank it up. Interesting. Learning how this weapon works. Oh, hello. Okay, let's get out of here. I'm standing in the open and not aiming particularly well. Hey, buddy. How do you feel about your head? There we go. Oh, hello. Oh, crap. That's not a solid wall at all. Is that guy dead at least?
You're not dead. Not dead.
I heard that. Hey, buddy. Sweet headshots. Oh, that's not even close, buddy. You want to try again? You are not making this. There you go. Oh, it came clean off. All right. Adapted straight to the murder part really quickly. Let's crank this thing till it can shoot properly. Buddy.
won't be able to pick this.
Oh. There's a bomb when you need one. How did you get in there? Hello. Saved you. Kind of. How'd you get in there? More cigarettes. Cool. Dog, how'd you get back out of there? What? Is my dog magic? Every time I turn around, it goes through a wall. I've been detected by someone, apparently. But they're not shooting me.
No more British occupation!
Back to England with you!
Join our tribe!
You lobster back knaves!
By the crown! Back to your homes! Have your tea back, you chicken imps!
To America!
No taxation without representation!
Remember, lads, you and my sea.
Let's send these crates back to London,
boys! We ride to Lexington.
Alright, sweet revolution, bros. There's the other side of the door. No, it's not. That's a totally different place. No, this is the other side of the door. Down there is the different place. Can I open it from here?
Don't think I can pick this.
Really? Okay. Well, no one's attacking me right now, so let's try this. Can I do some computer science-y stuff? Alright. Password required. Oh, wow. Fallout hacking. It's been a while. Select the potential password with the mouse 1. If your chosen password is incorrect, the number of letters that match the terminal's password will be displayed on the screen. Oh yeah! I remember liking these little passwords. Alright, we'll do Butch. Entry denied, likeness 0, so none of those letters in it. No Butch. So Reach, no. Plush, no. Carry. Yes.
That's it.
Nailed it. So unlock that gate. What you got back here? Got some cool weapons for me? Fusion core. Sweet. Don't know if I wanted that necessarily, but I took it because it was shiny. It's usually the only reason I need. Alright, now it's on the internet. Cats. Not a lot going on over here. Ooh. That's the normal way to get back up before the floor collapses. All right. Back to shooting people until their heads fall off. And they are somewhere. Gotta keep up on looting. Hey boy.
How you doing, buddy? Hey boy. Think you can find something for me? Any bad guys around, buddy?
Let's see if he can find anyone. He didn't find anyone. That means we're either in the clear or he's really bad at this. I haven't heard any shots for a while, so I think I might have taken them all out. These guys would be a good distraction if you're under attack. To set those guys up. Oh, hello. One of the guys I killed. Sweet, sweet ammo. Alright, enjoy being a naked, headless corpse. I'm gonna pretend I didn't say that just now. And continue on. What do we have around here?
I'm telling you, man, let's just get the hell out of here. We got no reason to hang around and get shot.
Hey guys. Don't want to alarm you, but headshot. 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 There we go.
Bastard.
Ow. Ow. Oh, God. Arm's been crippled. That's not good at all. Why is this room on fire? Stop doing that. Stop. No.
I'm coming for your little dog next.
What are you doing? Where are you at, buddy? Got him. Let's try not to kill our dog. Alright, well, that didn't go great. I don't know how much I like this weapon. It only shoots twice. Even if it is probably really powerful. Let's see. Power. Damage 30, energy. Yeah, it's pretty strong. My character's probably going to specialize with pistols to some extent, though. Or something along those lines. Let's go ahead and recover real quick. Oh, I can level up again. Let's see, quickly, Stimpak. I also need to Stimpak an individual part of my body. You can zoom in on this thing? How did I do that just now? Oh, you can right-click to move it around. Weird. Alright, cool. Points plus 30%. How do I apply it to specific parts though? Crap. I might have forgotten how to do that already. Or did I just already fix that? We're walking. I'll just look it up right after this episode, how to do that specific action. It might have told me yesterday. So I can level up again, apparently. Oh yeah, hit level 3. So, what would I want to go into next? Maybe something charisma related? Can I scroll down at all? Let's see, arrow keys. Oh, alt, next rank. Oh. Hey. So these actually change function over time. So like the Lone Wanderer goes from being you take less damage and get more carrying weight to rank 2 being you take 30% less damage and then you do 25% more damage. Does this thing have ranks? This one does not have ranks. It's just shooting things a lot. Let's see. What other kind of luck stats do we have? You find more bottle caps and containers. You just keep... You know just how to scavenge to keep the fight going and find more ammunition in containers. Or, bonus damage means that enemies will sometimes explode into a gory paste. Oh, get bloody mess right at the beginning of the playthrough. Then, more damage in combat. Oh yeah, just more damage in general. When an enemy explodes, nearby enemies may suffer the same fate. Required level 47. Alright. It's tempting to just get a flat 5% bonus. There's a lot of stats to go through here for sure. So more caps and containers, then even more caps, even more caps. You find even more bottle caps and containers, and there's a chance of enemies exploding in a shower of caps when you kill them. That's pretty fantastic. Level 40 though. Let's see. I think I want to be a straight up yeah. If you're gonna be like the dashing rogue, being a pistolero stealth character seems like it makes sense. Let's see. 20%. Oh yeah, let's just go ahead and improve our sneaking right now. That makes sense. If I'm gonna be all roguelike. So, 20% harder to detect while sneaking, 30% harder to detect and no longer trigger floor-based traps. Oh, that's fantastic. 40% and no longer trigger enemy mines, 50% and no longer, and running no longer adversely affects stealth, and engaging stealth causes distant enemies to lose you. Oh, so you can actually engage stealth to escape. Requires being level 38 though. But yeah, let's start getting some of these points into things that are directly related to what I'm going for. Hey doggy. America's Freedom Fighters. This mural commemorates the many sacrifices of the brave men and women of the United States Armed Forces, from Lexington to Concord on the shores of Iwo Jima, from the Sea of Tranquility to the Anchorage front line. Americans have fought and died through the ages to secure our nation's freedom. May their sacrifices remind us all that freedom is a privilege afforded to the many, yet a hard won by a noble few. There we go. It does look a lot like this. This in particular looks a lot like the cover of like a Medal of Honor game. That less so. Ooh, sweet ammo. So I haven't specialized in pistols yet, so I'm free to still keep using this without any sort of missed out on benefit. I think that guy might have just dropped me a cool pistol though. Anyone around? Ooh. This door opens to that open area, but there was the collapsed floor, so there might- Nope. Never mind. Oh, I probably could have snuck across that to script that whole fight. Hey, buddy. Dude gets around.
I'm coming in there, and I'm gonna skin every last one of you!
Come on, man, they ain't going nowhere. We got other shit to deal with.
You hear that? I gotta go take a little walk, but I'll be back, and you'll be dead. What the fuck was that? No!
Surprise! Oh crap.
Get off me!
There we go. Grab more of this sweet stuff. Just strip everyone around me. Oh crap, I picked up the body. Don't mind me. Alright. So you guys alarmed by me just walking in here and stripping everyone?
Man, I don't know who you are, but your timing's impeccable. Preston Garvey, Commonwealth Minutemen.
Maybe?
Minutemen? So nope. Now I'm traveling backward in time?
Protect the people at a minute's notice. That was the idea. So I joined up, wanted to make a difference. And I did, but things fell apart. Now it looks like I'm the last Minuteman left standing.
The world's changed so much. None of this makes sense.
You all right? Listen,
that ain't it.
We need your help. And then maybe we can help you, huh? What brought you out here?
Who's around that can find a missing person?
Used to have a few good trackers in this group. Not many now.
Hey.
A month ago, there were 20 of us. Yesterday, there were 8. Now we're 5. First, it was the ghouls in Lexington, and now this mess.
Ghouls? What are ghouls?
God
damn it. Wow. You really aren't from around here, are you? Ghouls are irradiated people. Most are just like you and me. They look pretty messed up and live for a long time, but they're still just people. The ones I'm talking about are different. The radiations rotted their brains, made them feral. They'll rip you apart just as soon as look at you.
Nope.
Anyway, we figured Concord would be a safe place to settle. Those raiders proved us wrong. But, well, we do have one idea.
Will it be enough to stop those maniacs?
Sturgis, tell him.
There's a crashed vertebrate up on the roof. Old school, pre-war. You might have seen it. Well, looks like one of its passengers left behind a seriously sweet goodie. We're talking a full suit of Cherry T-45 power armor. Military issue.
That's some serious protection.
Oh, it gets better. Get the suit. You can rip the minigun right off the vertibird. Do that, and those raiders get an express ticket to hell. You dig?
And I can use the minigun like a rifle?
Don't see why not. It'll have a manual trigger. Just aim it at the bad guys and do the old spray and pray. Now, as for the armor, it's out of juice. Probably has been for 100 years. It can be powered up again. But we're a bit stuck.
So, what's the solution?
What you'll need is an old pre-war FC. A standardized fusion core. Your high-grade, long-term nuclear battery used by the military and some companies way back when. And we know right where to find one.
But we can't get to the damn thing. It's down in the basement. Locked behind a security gate. Look, I fix stuff. I tinker. Bypassing security ain't exactly my forte. You could give it a shot.
What are you looking for again?
A fusion core. It's kind of a fancy battery. They used one here in the museum to power the exhibits a long time ago. There's one in the basement behind a security gate. You'll need to pick the lock or hack the computer to open it.
Actually, I already grabbed a fusion core. We're set.
Well, all right. Maybe our luck's finally turning around. Once you jack the core into the power armor and grab that minigun, those raiders will know they picked the wrong fight. Good luck.
All right. That was my pro speedrun tactic, was to go in and grab that fusion core in advance. Actually, that was actually, it's called strategy, not inefficiency. Where are you going, dog? Where are you going? All right, you, get off our balcony. Go. Oopsie. Oh, I didn't mean to click. Oh, it was really stuck in there, wasn't it? Gross. Come on. Come on. Bye. We gotta do like adult organization stuff here. Saving the world and all that. We can't have a bunch of corpses hanging out in our entryway. That's kind of also our entryway, you know? But now this hallway's nice. Maybe not.